Hi everyone, my name is Mehmood Sheikh and from past few videos I have been working on developing a multi-search and multi-filter application using CorePHP, Ajax and MySQL database. In my last video I completed the functionality of searching any specific record using the search box. Okay, and in this video I will discuss about displaying this drop-down the moment when you click on this drop-down arrow. Okay, and when you click on this drop-down arrow, this drop-down will get appear along with the checkbox and the details of task. Okay, so that's what we will be going to cover in this video. Okay, and whenever user wants to filter any of the task based on the selected task, okay, suppose I have selected responsive web development and HRMS development, and now when I click on apply, then the records related to only those tasks and with the names of employee name to whom these tasks are assigned and the starting date, ending date and the status will also gets fetched from the table and start appearing inside this table. Okay, so that's what we'll be going to cover in this video. Okay, so we will be working only on the functionality of loading these tasks from the table and displaying this task in this form of a drop down along with these check boxes. Okay, and the functionality of filtering the records based on the selected checkbox we will be going to do in the next video. Okay, so now let us start our discussion on displaying this drop down menu along with this task details. Okay, so this is my already built application, and now I will go to the application which I'm currently working on. This is my project. Okay, and the name of the project is Data Filter, and here you can see I have already created a database with the name Data Filter, and in that I have created two tables. One is Data Filter and another one is Status. Okay, and inside Data Filter I have stored all the records. Okay, now let us come to our editor. Okay, so here you can see this is our table. Okay, and in this table I want to display that drop down box which contains the list of tasks. Okay, and this table starts with the table head and it contains a table row, and in that table row, actually this is our header row. Okay, and in that table row I had created employee name header, task details header, start date, end date and action headers. Okay, and I'm going to display that task details drop down inside task details header. Okay, so here you can see I have created an unordered list. Okay, so all these are bootstrap classes like drop down. Okay, and then we have an anchor tag which points to hash. Okay, and then I have included a data toggle attribute which has the class as drop down, and this class is also from Bootstrap framework, and we have a class as drop down toggle. Okay, and then I have a element B, okay, which has the class as caret, okay, which is used for displaying a drop down symbol which you can see here. Okay, so now let me just refresh, and when I click on this you can see nothing is happening because I have not included that code inside this list. Okay, so now let's do that. So now here you can see once this anchor tag gets completed, and now I have created another unordered list with the class as drop down menu. Okay, so this drop down menu class belongs to Bootstrap. Okay, and I have given it some stylings like padding. Okay, and then overflow, I have overflow towards y axis I have set to auto, and I have given that window a height as 250 pixel. Okay, now let us see that. Okay, now I have refreshed, and when I click on this you can see it started displaying this drop down menu. Okay, okay, so now we need to bring all the task details from the table and start displaying those records inside this drop down. Okay, so now let's do that. Okay, so here I have created in PHP tag. Okay, and I have included my database configuration file. Okay, which you can see here I have that file where I'm connecting my PHP script with our data filter. Okay, and then I have written a query to select ID as well as task details from the data filter table, and now I'm going to execute that query. Okay, MySQL query connect. I am passing the connect. Okay, which is coming from the db.php file, and I am passing this query to this MySQLi query function. Okay, and then so I'm going to iterate. Okay, so this MySQL query will return me the data, and that gets stored inside this total row, and then I will use an if condition to check is there any records present inside the table or not. Okay, so this SQL query will return me some set of records, and I'm going to iterate over those records. So before iterating those records, I will check whether we have records present in the table. Okay, if we found that yes, there are greater than zero, that means at least there is one record present inside the table, then I'm going to iterate using for each. I'm going to iterate over those records using for each, and I will pass the total row in that for each, and then I will create a list, and in that list I have included a label with a class of checkbox, and then I have created a checkbox, an input of type checkbox, and I have given it an ID as check. This ID I'm going to use in my jQuery code for filtering the records based on task details. Okay, and I have given it a name as ID. Okay, and to the value attributes of this checkbox, I have assigned the ID of each and every record. Okay, and here I am displaying the details, task details. Okay, so now let me just show you that. Okay, I will refresh, and when I click on this drop down arrow, you can see all the tasks which were saved inside this table now gets loaded from the table and started displaying in the form of a drop down. Okay, so from here now I can check. Okay, I can check any of the task, and I can filter, I can get the data which belongs to that particular task. Okay, so this is our thing about fetching the details of task. Okay, now apart from displaying the task details and checkboxes, we also need to display the button. Okay, which yes, here you can see if we didn't find any record inside the table, then we will display no data found. Since we have enough records present in our data filter table or task in our table, now that's why it's not displaying no data found. Okay, instead it's loading all the tasks. Okay, now next is we need to create another div. Okay, under this UL. Okay, I have created a div with a class of model footer and button as type as submit. Okay, button is of type submit. Okay, and I have given it an ID as find tasks, and I have given it a class as btn, btn primary, btn small. Okay, so this class belongs to Bootstrap. Okay, I have given it a name as apply. Okay, now I'm going to save it, and I will refresh, and now when I click on this drop down arrow, a drop down gets started displaying along with the checkboxes and the label and the names of the task. Okay, and at the bottom right side you can see there is an apply button. Okay, so if I want to filter, then I will be just checking on these checkboxes, and when I click on apply, the required data gets fetched out from the table and started displaying inside this text, inside this table. Okay, yes, so this is everything about loading the task details from MySQL table. Okay, if you guys like this video, click on like button, share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel, and thanks for watching.